So, before it's roasted, coffee looks like this. This is the seed of a coffee cherry from a coffee plant.
And finally, Philam Jonathan Pasquale is brewing something special. His second coffee shop in Georgia, this one he calls Opo, serves coffee with respect, he says. But what sets Opo Coffee Shop apart from others in the area is its coffee training lab. It's the only one in the Atlanta metro area that offers specialty coffee association certificates. And this, a roastery.
So this cooks it, roasts it, and then this is a big cooling tray. And then once it's in this cooling tray and cooled down, we can bag it up, and then it's ready for someone to purchase or for us to grind and brew at our coffee bar.
And for the first time, Pasquale is offering specialty coffee from the Philippines, Mount Apo Coffee from Davao del Sur Province.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website and YouTube channel. I'm Henny Espinosa. Stay with us, Kapamilya.
Well, six people remain missing hours after a massive cargo ship slammed into a bridge in Baltimore, Maryland. Crippled by a loss of power, the Singapore-flagged container vessel Dali, bound for Sri Lanka, knocked down a large section of the Francis Scott Key Bridge, sending vehicles and people into the river below. Rescuers were able to pull two survivors to safety. The ship reported the power failure before impact, enabling officials to stop traffic before the collapse.
This is very much still a search and rescue mission. We are still actively looking for survivors. We know, and that's the pledge we've made to these families, and this is still very much an active search and rescue mission. And there is not a single resource that we will hold off on deploying. I have already authorized the deployment of everything from air, land, and sea resources to make sure that this search and rescue operation is carried out to its fullest intent.
The accident has shut down one of the busiest ports on the eastern seaboard. The U.S. transportation chief admits rebuilding will not be easy.
The federal government will provide all of the support that they need for as long as it takes. This is no ordinary bridge. This is one of the cathedrals of American infrastructure. It has been part of the skyline of this region for longer than many of us have been alive. So the path to normalcy will not be easy. It will not be quick. It will not be inexpensive. But we will rebuild together.
U.S. President Joe Biden commending the quick response of the U.S. Coast Guard and the fast action of Maryland officials, which prevented an even bigger tragedy. Biden says he will send all the federal resources needed to handle the incident, adding the federal government will shoulder the cost of rebuilding. Biden also addressing speculations the incident was a deliberate attack.
It's my intention that federal government will pay for the entire cost of reconstructing that bridge. And I expect the Congress to support my effort. Everything so far indicates that this was a terrible accident. At this time, we have no other indication, no other reason to believe there's any intentional act here.
Israel confirms reports of the death of a top Hamas military leader. The Israeli military says Hamas deputy military commander Marwan Issa was killed in an offensive earlier this month. There has been no immediate comment from the militant group. Issa was at the top of Israel's most wanted list, together with the head of Hamas military wing and its leader in Gaza, who were believed to have masterminded the October 7 attack in southern Israel, triggering the war. U.S. Defense Chief Lloyd Austin meets with Israeli counterpart Yoav Gallant at the Pentagon to discuss Washington's concerns on the ongoing war. The U.S. has backed Israel with both military and diplomatic support, but has voiced frustration at the mounting death toll and worsening humanitarian situation.
We will discuss developments in Gaza and the means to achieve our goals, the destruction of Hamas organization and bringing back the Israeli hostages back home.
In Gaza today, the number of civilian casualties is far too high and the amount of humanitarian aid is far too low. Gaza is suffering a humanitarian catastrophe, and the situation is getting even worse. Now, we continue to share the goal of seeing Hamas defeated. So we'll discuss alternative approaches to target Hamas elements.
A separate Israeli delegation was supposed to visit Washington, but their trip was scrapped by Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu after the U.S. abstained in Monday's vote on a U.N. Security Council resolution that called for a ceasefire in Gaza.